Now we have this issue of Russia and its role in the election and whether they tried to tilt the election to Donald Trump. And you have, alongside that, reports, and there was another in USA Today this weekend, about his business dealings in Russia, which apparently are extensive, including financing of some of his projects, if this report is true. We don't know if that's the case. We have no idea what his financial entanglements might be or might not be in Russia. And there's only one way to resolve those questions, which is why presidents for the last four decades have released their tax returns so people understood exactly what their finances were and where their conflicts might be. The fact that Donald Trump refuses to do that, and I don't think we're ever going to see his tax returns, is deeply disturbing. He's got global entanglements, we know that, dealings all over the world. And we don't know where his financing comes from, what his obligations and entanglements are, to make judgments as to whether he is making decisions on the basis of the national interest or his own pecuniary interest.
So, David,
and that's very disturbing.
I mean, but David, you've heard the Trump campaign, Trump team, sowing some seeds of doubt that the Russians were behind the hacking. They don't believe it. And we just had Vladimir Posner, veteran Russian journalist, on, who said the CIA should prove it. We're not just going to take them at their word. They should produce the evidence. Does the CIA ever produce evidence to show exactly how they connect the dots?
No, because to do so would be to expose their means and their operatives and would undermine our ability to gather intelligence. But look, 16 intelligence agencies and the FBI have all agreed that this happened, first of all. I don't think there's any question in the minds of our intelligence agencies or most members of Congress who've seen the intelligence that the hacking actually occurred. They've further suggested that it was to help Mr. Trump. But right. Even if it wasn't to help Trump, it's still a huge encroachment on our electoral process, a deep source of concern. And that should be a concern for Republicans and Democrats. I don't think the Trump folks are doing him a favor by continually pushing back against this. So they stand with Vladimir Posner on this question. I'm not sure that's going to rally the country in the corner of the president-elect. They should be for a full and complete investigation of this. And if they're not, then people need to understand why they're not.
Ax, do you think that there winds up being an accommodation of this need for disclosure by Trump? Because everybody keeps running up against the same wall. Is there any chance that you see what you're seeing right now with Russia when it comes to Trump, that you have a bipartisan sealed congressional committee hearing, which is what they're asking for, what Nunez wanted with Clapper, right? You know, the headlines ignore that Clapper says he tried to get Nunez three times. But the outside is, we're going to have a confidential hearing. Trump has to come with his guys, put out his taxes, let us review them, bipartisan, so that Congress can have confidence, and then you try and put in some penalties against leaking, because it's a classified hearing, so that they don't leak out any of his information. So then at least you have the people who need to know most about the conflicts know. Any chance of that?
Well, that would be great, and that would be good for the country, Chris. One of the tests for the Republican leadership in Congress now is, will they insist on such an investigation? They've said they're for an investigation, but they've sort of hinted that it would be a limited investigation, not the select committee that John McCain, for example, and some others have called for. This should be fully aired, and even as you suggest, if it is done in part in private and in secret, and the members get to examine evidence that the public can, I think it almost necessarily has to be that way. There should be a full investigation. This has cast a huge cloud over this incoming administration, and it's going to cast a cloud over every decision that's made relative to Russia unless there is a full and complete probe and a conclusion. And so, you know, this is a big test, not just for the president, but for the Congress.
Yep. David Axelrod, great to talk to you. Thank you.
Okay, guys, have a good day.
You too.